गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी स्टडी अबाउट द डिटर्मिनेट्स और द सोर्सेज ऑफ ह्यूमन कैपिटल फॉर्मेशन। इन लास्ट वीडियो वी हैव हैड अ टॉक अबाउट ऑल दीज। टुडे वी विल स्टडी ऑल दीज इन डिटेल। व्हाट आर द डिटर्मिनेट्स और द सोर्सेज ऑफ ह्यूमन कैपिटल फॉर्मेशन? दीज आर द एस्पेक्ट्स विच works as the way of increase in human capital. These are the ways by which we make our population a human capital. What are these? These are first expenditure on education. By expenditure on education, what we do? We give knowledge to our workforce, and that workforce became a capital for the country. This is the most important aspect of or the determinants or determinant of human capital formation. We have seen that most families decide to incur huge expenditure on education even when they have to raise loan. Why? Because returns on such expenditure are sustainably large, substantially large. It means whether we invest a large, big amount on education, if our child has got good education, he give us a lot in return. That is very much more than what we have the expenditure we have done. When we got a good education, that help us in living a good life, and in total lifespan a person earns a lot if he had done a good expenditure on education. If he has not done a good expenditure on education, then the person may become a liability for the country, not the capital. The second determinant is expenditure on health. It has been said that a sound soul mind lives in a sound body. So the expenditure on its health makes a man move very efficient and capable of working. The person becomes more productive. He may work for longer periods, he may work more, and he can earn more, he can generate more for the country. And the country needs to expend lesser amount on him because he is healthy. So the government or the country need not to make expenditure on his health, and he works more for the country rather than the other person. So, moreover, the benefit goes to the GDP, and the GDP increases in a good speed. If there are very sick people in the country, then the GDP suffers. So that is then the own job training. If your workforce is unskilled, inefficient, then their productivity will be low. They cannot produce much more. But if your workforce is well trained, then their efficiency increases and their productivity increases. This is why many firms uses the on-job training programs. They undertake the on-job training program so that the person became the skilled and the productivity increase, his productivity increases, so then the benefit goes to the firm. And if one firm is benefited by that, the benefit goes to the country as well. So this is another important aspect in the formation of human capital. Then study program for adults. Adults means the person over the age of 18 years. We have the formal education system in which the children studies the primary education, then the secondary and the university level education. Other than that, the government and the NGOs organize the program for the adults, the person who are at the age of more than 20 years, 25 years. They have done program for those as well who are illiterate, who didn't get a good opportunity for study in their childhood. They can study in the older age and they can enhance their productivity and they can become a human capital for country. Migration also contributes in human capital formation, because what it utilizes the inactive skills of people. Many people who are not able to work at their birthplace, they can go at any other place and they can get a work which they can do. So they become the human capital. Now what cost we need to bear in migration? That is the cost of transportation from one place to another, and the cost of living in different social environment. Every place has a different social environment and the person needs to live there and to become settled there. But there are many gains as well. The person get the better job opportunity, then he earns good amount and the GDP of country also increases due to that. The expenditure on information related to job, related to education institution, that also should be reached to the person so that they can get a good job as per their skills and their abilities. These are the determinants which makes a person human capital. Now, the role of human capital formation and economic growth, what relation both of these have? That is change in emotional and material environment of growth. Human capital formation generates a change in emotional and material environment of growth. That is in the way emotional environments become conducive to growth as people tend to acquire growth oriented attitude. And then the material environment become helpful for growth as society now possesses higher number of skilled and trained workers. Then higher productivity of physical capital. The physical capital, it means the machines, they give higher productivity because human capital is now, we have the human capital, the specialized engineers, skilled workers, they can work in a better way with the machines. Innovative skills. Now, as the people have skills, they can go for the innovative ways. High rate of participation and equality. Lot of people get involved in the economic activities, and this is how we get a lot of labor force in the country. So this is the role of human capital formation in economic growth. This is all for today. In the next video, we will study about the problems facing in human capital formation in India. Thank you.